Hi, Dr. Osborne here with Web Wellness University. Today I want to talk a little bit about joint and muscle pain. Joint and muscle pain are two of the top reasons that people go and see their doctor on a regular basis. It's mainly because we have these lifestyles that are very sedentary. We sit at a computer desk all day. We commute several hours in a car. So the posture is always going forward. It's always, the neck is always under excessive pressure. The joints are not adequately moved. And so the old saying goes, use it or lose it. When we're sedentary and we're not using the joints, then they start to deteriorate. And so one of the first things that people grab for is they grab for pain medications. And there are different types of pain medications, but I want to talk specifically about a type of pain medication that people take very commonly that has an influence on certain vitamins and minerals in the body. And that class of medications are called NSAIDs. And NSAIDs is an acronym. It stands for non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. Okay, and so NSAIDs are drugs like naproxen, they're drugs like ibuprofen. Okay, these are, you can buy some of these, you can buy over the counter, some of them are prescription grade. Other classes of drugs that we have are called COX inhibitors, and that would be like Celebrex, that would be an example of a non-steroidal anti-inflammatory. So let's talk about some of the problems with these particular types of medications. One, we're trying to reduce pain. So in essence, the drug is designed to reduce pain by blocking a chemical, different chemicals depending on the type of drug. So these two would block a chemical called arachidonic acid, and this one would block another chemical called cyclooxygenase. And so that's not important to memorize, but the point being, they block chemicals that induce inflammation, and because it's inflammation that actually causes pain. So what we're doing is we're blocking chemicals to reduce pain. Now, the bigger question would always be, why is the pain there in the first place? But that's for another day. But what I want to talk about are the side effects of using NSAIDs for long periods of time. Remember, most people, when they have chronic pain issues and they take an aspirin a day or they take an ibuprofen a day, have no idea what is actually occurring internally with their internal chemistry. And so that's what I want to talk about, the vitamin and mineral deficiencies that are induced as a result of being on these medications. So one of the things that happens with side effect-wise with chronic non-steroidal anti-inflammatory use is we actually interfere with vitamin C. Okay. Number two, we interfere with another nutrient called folic acid. It's a B vitamin. And number three, we interfere with iron. So, these medications interfere with these particular nutrients. So let's talk about some of the functions of these nutrients. Remember, joint and muscle pain, the goal of taking an NSAID is to reduce pain, right? So if by reducing pain, and at the same time we're reducing pain, we induce these deficiencies, and these deficiencies have an effect on how we perceive pain, then now we've just created a chronic situation. So let's talk about vitamin C. One of the things that's important to understand about vitamin C is that vitamin C, first of all, is necessary for the formation of collagen. Now, collagen is a protein that your body makes, and it's the backbone protein that your body uses to make muscles, to make tendons and ligaments, as well as to make joints. So when we induce a vitamin C deficiency, what ends up happening is we have a reduction in joint healing. So we get a reduced joint healing, which in turn leads to a joint that is more predisposed to injury. So we're taking these medications, we're reducing the pain, and as we've got less pain, we go out and we try to do more than what we should maybe do. So maybe we try to run a marathon, we go out and we become a weekend warrior. And so we do something, we're already predisposed to our joint not healing because we've been contributing to vitamin C deficiency. So now we're also prone to injury. So we go out and we're a weekend warrior this weekend and we injure something, and because of this vitamin C deficiency, we end up needing to take more of the medication. So one of the things this medication does is it induces vitamin C deficiency. Vitamin C deficiency causes a reduced joint healing, but also causes the reduced ability, okay, for the protein structures in your joints, muscles, and ligaments to form. So we get weaker joints, muscles, and ligaments. one of the symptoms of vitamin C deficiency is bleeding gums, because your gums are made out of that collagen protein. And so when we have weak gums, they start to bleed. Well, the same thing happens internally. When you have weak collagen, you have weaker bones, weaker muscles, weaker tendons, weaker ligaments, weaker joints. So you affect your joints and your muscles, and therefore subsequently increase joint and muscle pain problems. So that's one element of what NSAIDs do. They can create a vitamin C deficiency that can lead to those issues. Now, number two, we can also create a folic acid deficiency. Now, what's important to understand about folic acid is folic acid is a B vitamin, and one of its jobs in the body is to help to produce energy. It helps your body to make components of energy so that you can get up in the morning, you can start your day without a cup of coffee, without a boost or a dose of caffeine. Because of its role, also, folic acid plays a role in joint integrity, just like vitamin C. You actually can't form cartilage without folic acid. So if you're low on folic acid, you can have a reduced ability to form cartilage. Well, that leads to a degradation of cartilage. So let's think about that in terms of a joint. All joint surfaces are lined by cartilage. And cartilage does not have a direct blood supply. So what we get is we get thin cartilage that becomes malnourished. And thin cartilage that is malnourished becomes inflamed when it's used. And so then we end up with joint and muscle pain as a result of having folic acid deficiency. The other nutrient that we have here is iron. And iron is an extremely important nutrient for multiple functions, but one of the main functions iron serves is it makes a structure in your red blood cells called hemoglobin, and that helps you carry oxygen. And remember, it's oxygen. As oxygen is delivered into your muscles can contract and relax and make energy, and they can work effectively. If we're having oxygen deprivation, that actually, what we call that is anemia. And so we're lethargic, we have brain fog, we're tired, we can sleep for 12 hours and we still wake up exhausted, we have muscle spasm, and we have muscle pain. So again, we're talking about taking a medication, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, to reduce joint and muscle pain. We end up taking this medication chronically over a long period of time. We can end up inducing these vitamin and mineral deficiencies. Inducing these vitamin and mineral deficiencies can actually now lead to the same problem that we started out trying to treat in the first place. So it's kind of another situation where we're chasing our own tail, trying to treat the symptom without addressing the origin. So I hope this was helpful for you. This is Dr. Osborne with Web Wellness University, wishing you excellent health. Have a great day.